Let us consider a liquid taken in a container. Say this is the liquid present in the container. So to the side wall, a capillary tube is connected. Length of the capillary tube is L and its radius is R. So we know that automatically liquid passes through this capillary and falls. Imagine this is a container collecting the liquid. So what is the volume rate of flow through this capillary? If I take a capillary tube of length L and radius R, the volume rate of flow, volume rate means meter cube per second, V by T we are taking. The volume rate of flow is given by this Poiseuille's equation. This tells about the volume rate of flow of fluid through a given capillary tube is given by pi p r power 4 by h l eta, where p is the pressure difference between the two ends of the capillary. So pressure difference between these two points, this end and this end, here only atmospheric pressure acts, but here if I assume this h is the height of the liquid column above this point, then P becomes equal to HDG. But basic Poiseuille's equation suggests the volume rate of flow of fluid through a given capillary tube V is given by pi P r power 4 by 8 L eta. Here volume is in meter cube per second. This is called Poiseuille's equation. Now, if I take a resistor, say current is passing through this resistance, R is the resistance and let V is the potential difference. According to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR or I is equal to V by R. So due to the potential difference V, the passing current I is given by V by R. Now if I compare the same thing here, in the case of resistance, due to potential difference current is passing. Through this capillary, liquid is flowing because of a pressure difference. Here, pressure difference is responsible for flow of liquid. Here, potential difference is responsible for flow of current. So, in the similar way, if I write this equation, this can be taken as P divided by remaining terms, take it to the denominator, pi r power 4. So, if I compare this equation and this equation, these two, I'll write this as P by R. Here I is equal to V by R. Due to the potential difference V, current passing through it is I, so I is equal to V by R. R is called a resistance. Due to pressure difference P, liquid passing is V, and this R, this can be taken as resistance offered by the capillary tube. Capillary tube resistance for the flow of fluid. So R is nothing but 8 L eta by pi R power 4. This is called the resistance offered by the capillary tube. Sorry, 8 L eta divided by pi R power 4. The resistance offered by the capillary tube for the flow of fluid. So resistance is directly proportional to length of the capillary and inversely proportional to fourth power of the radius of the capillary tube. R, resistance of the capillary tube, is directly proportional to L by R power 4. Now suppose if I join two resistances, two capillaries, say this is one capillary tube having length L1, radius is R1. To this, let us say another capillary is connected. Say its length is L2, radius is R2. Resistance of this one, let us say R1, this is R2. So R1 is equal to, so already we know equation for R, 8L eta by pi R power 4. This is 8L1, this is R1. R2 similarly, 8L2 eta divided by pi R2 power 4. This is called resistors capillaries connected in series. the total resistance offered by the combination R is equal to R1 plus R2. So in both the cases 8 eta by pi common, so L1 by R1 power 4 plus L2 by R2 power 4, this is the effective resistance offered by the capillaries connected in series. Suppose if I say R1 is equal to R2, then the effective resistance becomes equal to 2R1. If a capillary, identical capillary tube is joined in series with the capillary tube, the resistance becomes double. But V is equal to P by R, V inversely proportional to R. So if identical capillary tube is connected in series, then automatically volume rate of flow decreases. That means to this container, let us say one capillary is connected first, the volume rate is V. If I put another identical capillary tube, same length and same radius, then volume rate of flow becomes V by 2. Because resistance is doubled, so volume rate of flow becomes automatically halved. If I consider capillaries connected in parallel, so this one side capillary L1 R1, on the other side another capillary is connected, say L2 R2, same height, pressure difference is considered to be same, the height of the liquid is assumed to be same here, whether I take from this side or this side, then this is called parallel combination. The effective resistance is given by 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So when capillaries are connected in parallel, the equivalent resistance decreases. Suppose if I say identical capillary tubes, then R in P is equal to R by N. N identical capillary tubes are connected in parallel. If it is in series, RS becomes N into R. Effective resistance increases.